Yo guys, welcome back to the channel. We're currently top 500 almost, and like early season, like I think season ended like 2-3 days ago. And yeah, let's jump into our first game. And obviously I'm using poison, by the way. I think I'm going to start using poison. Poison is actually pretty good, like, yeah, it's like really, really good. Okay, battle ramp, so this is pretty good because this is most likely going to be 3M, which is a good matchup for me. Cannon up high just in case if, you know, went like power prediction or something like that, you know. Is that going to get a hit? I mean, if I was quick enough, I would have went 24 Musketeer, and then not only would have killed the Barbarian, but would have also killed the Rylane. But this is, oh, here's Magic Archer. Okay. So obviously this is going to, I think this matchup, having Fireball is much better because of the Magic Archer. He might go for Battle Ram, so I need to get my Musketeer ready, because I don't have my cannon. Okay, nice, I'll just Ice Spirit that, Skeletons, and this should be... Okay, it's Ice Golem, yeah, nice, nice. Yeah, so with this type of matchup, I wish I had Fireball instead of... Wait, yes, cannon card. Oh, nice, nice. Musketeer target there, guys. Nice, 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 nice. He spent so much elixir there, so I'm gonna go hog left lane immediately. I don't think he'll be able to... Okay, Bandit, that's alright. My hog rider will get 2 hits. Okay, so this is a bridge spam, but I don't think he has the P.E.K.K.A. So yeah, bridge spam decks, I think I would rather prefer Fireball, obviously. It's just so much better. I'm not too sure. I haven't played against bridge spam with poison, but he has a Magic Archer, so obviously I think Fireball will be better. But yeah, fine. Okay, I'll just poison that. Oh, wait. Now he knows that I'm using poison, so... Now he's gonna be more, like, aggressive with his Magic Archer and stuff. Usually poison is, like, a surprise factor. Like, they won't know you're using it. But now he obviously does, because I just used it. Okay, so if we... I don't think he has a big spell... Yeah, he doesn't have a big spell, because he would have used it if he had it. Okay, yeah, this guy's playing pretty well. This is going to be... This is going to be pretty annoying to defend. I don't know. He's spamming me really well. Like, he's going, he's dueling pressure, and he's like, you know, he's pressuring really well. Okay, I'll just poison that. I mean, the poison is going to kill that cannon cast, so that was pretty nice, but... Oh, nice. Ice Golem made the put Magic Archer stay in the poison, so that was good. Okay. I think I need to go for a hog, because I can't just let him, like, build these big-ass pushes, but I need to, like... Okay, nice. I got it here. I might even just... Nice, 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 nice. So, I think the poison should be able to take out that around. Nice. That was... Wow. That poison got so much value. It killed literally everything. That was actually really good poison. And I'm already back to another poison to kill. Nice, even hit the bandit. It's gonna log. And do I have to ice spray? Yeah, I have to ice spray that. Okay, so there's no need to be aggressive here. Yeah, like what I'm supposed to do? I can't go for a hog in the left lane. I can't get a hog in the right lane. Like, there's literally no way of going hogs. Of hog. Okay, nice. Yeah, this is getting pretty stressful to defend, I don't know. I mean, the good thing is that he doesn't have a big spell, but just he has so much spam, so much annoying cards. Okay. Just gonna log it as well, and I think that should... Okay, nice. That Magic Archer is going to be pretty... Hopefully Musketeer can kill it, please. Oh, you're so annoying. Okay, I'll just Musketeer the cannon card, then just poison the right lane. Well, I think that's a really nice poison. Wow, that's actually a really nice poison. It literally killed everything. And that cannon card also killed the Magic Archer. Really nice defense. Okay, I'll take cannon. I think we're fine. Skeleton's log. Yeah, nice, nice, nice. Yeah, I think we... Oh, gosh. Nice. I think this is, yeah, GG. So that's a pretty good matchup. He played it pretty well. I mean, like, he was like I was, that was pretty stressful. He was like applying pressure, like really, like him, his pressure was really good. He was like going both lanes. It was pretty hard, like pretty stressful to defend and all that. Yeah, he didn't have a big spot, so that was like another really good thing. But let's jump into our next game. Okay, so we found another game against Corbo. Okay, so like Ice Spirit. So this is probably like only one deck uses Ice Spirit. It's literally just 2.6. What? No, what is this? Oh wait, it's the Hog Xe deck. Yeah. Hog Xe deck. Okay, so I'm not too sure what the matchup is for this deck. They can easily rock a cycle and they can like easily just defend like really really even if they don't have Nader in hand, it's so easy for them to defend. Yes, yeah. Like the Valkyrie and the Ice Spear and the Log, it's just sometimes pretty hard to break through. Like in triple and double, he's just gonna start rocker cycling me, and it's gonna be pretty hard to break through. So you wanna get your damage in single leg, so like you wanna be up in damage, and I am up like 200, so that's pretty nice. Now I think poison is better in this matchup because it does more crown tower damage. Okay, nice, perfect timing. So we might need to. Okay, I thought he would rocket it. He actually went for goblins in there. Okay, so nice. Margaret actually got a hit. So when you want to always go Ice Golem Hog when they have Nader, like, because it'd be pretty annoying from the defender. You can always like predict Log on this. We got on the goblins. Okay, that's nice. I'll just Ice Spirit. Nice, and Musket will go left lane. So there's no point in going Ice Golem because he will just go for Valkyrie and he's gonna play it either way. No, he's not. But yeah, there's no point going Ice Golem because he had Valkyrie in hand. So yeah. So yeah, once again, nice, perfect timing. He doesn't have Nader in hand, so yeah, it's gonna be okay. Nice, I got one here, so that was really nice. He might rocket me now. Okay, that's fine. That's fine. Okay, yeah, this is what I'm going to talk about. This is what I'm talking about. He just uses Nader, so yeah, look at that. Like, I'm telling you, it's pretty hard to break through. They can just easily rocket cycle. Well, nice. Musketeer stayed alive. He just uses Nader, so I'm going to go Hog with Log immediately for the goblins. Nice. Look at that. That's what I'm like. Look, I can't even break through. It's so easy for them to defend. I mean, it's easy for me to defend too, but they have rocket. They can just rocket cycle. Nice. Musketeer does take out Darkskushner. So I'm going to go Hog Poison here because it's fine going aggressive because I can defend his push really easy. Just cannon. One hit, please. Oh, that was close. Yeah, we are up by a lot, so this should be GG's. Yeah, no, this should be GG's. Yeah, so this is like, I'm not too sure what the matchup is. I mean, this guy didn't really like play that well, I guess. I don't know, but yeah, because they can like easily rock a cycle and still like be able to defend pretty easy. So yeah, I'm not too sure what the matchup is, but poison is enough. So yeah, GG's. Pretty nice win. You want to like when you go Ice Golem Hog, you want to like always prediction log immediately because like there's a really high chance that they'll wanna go for goblins because they want to kill your Ice Golem as soon as possible. So then they'll be able to nail your Hog. But yeah, pretty nice win. Okay, so we found another game against this guy. So I have Hog my starting hand, so I can probably just go Hog first play. Oh, that's so annoying that I don't have my. Okay, I have Log, so I'm not gonna log. I'm not gonna go for a cannon for the Hog Rider because if I did, then it would have been over committing. And if I did go for a cannon, then he would have been. If he was using like a Hog cycle deck, like I don't know, like a mirror matchup, he would have been able to cycle back to another. another hog, but this probably isn't a mirror matchup. Okay, I'll just Musketeer for the Inferno Drag. Let's see what spells he has. It's gonna print, okay. No idea. I might need to use my cannon to defend the prince. I think it'll be okay. He went with arrows, so I'm gonna go with the hog ice spirit because pretty much wasted three elixir. Mega Knight Prince Hog, really. Okay, what's his spell? Just don't be an annoying spell, and it'll be like, don't be like EQ or something like that, or even like lightning. Oh, come on, bro. That cannon was so annoying, it didn't die, so I have to go for a cannon up high. I have to also go for another Musketeer. I think that should be fine. Yeah, nice. Okay, I'm gonna log. No need, because we both knew that I had log in hand, so I had a feeling he wasn't gonna use his skeleton on me, and he uses Electro Wizard and Fireball. So yeah, luckily I didn't get for a log because it would have been pretty much a waste. Oh, so yes, Fireball Arrows. Okay, Fireball Arrows. So I think he's used all of, I'm pretty sure he's used all of his cards. It's gonna be pretty annoying to defend, like the Mega Knight Prince and then the Hog. So Fireball Arrows. Okay. So then I have Fireball in hand, so I can't really Fireball my... I could have went Hog left lane, but I didn't really want to because he would have probably just went for a skeleton or something like that. I didn't want a prediction log, because if he didn't go for a skeleton on me, then I would have been overcommitting and be way too much elixir I've been spending. Yeah. I'm just gonna go. Okay. Cannon, please. Nice, nice. Okay, that's not nice. That's not nice. That's not nice. That's not... Actually, that is nice. Look at his tower. Wow. That hog got nice damage on his tower. So, yeah. This is probably. Well, it's not GG's yet, but it's looking like it. I'm not too sure what the matchup is. It's for sure my matchup, but yeah, it can get pretty tough, like defending and. Well, that's yeah. Because I went for Mega Knight in the back, so that poison was okay, because Musketeer will kill it and will also survive. So I know that poison log does 365. Yep, so that means two poison is enough, but I think this Hog Rider will 100% get a hit. Yeah, nice, GG's. Yeah, not that bad of a matchup, it's pretty easy matchup, but yeah. Like, you want to, like, you know, obviously, like, cannon for his Hog Rider, you want to cycle Musketeer first, make him Fireball Arrows here, then you can get for another Musketeer, and he can't really... you know, kill your next Musketeer, but you just don't want to overcommit, because if you do, then like you will just have a huge counter push and it'll be pretty annoying to defend. Okay, so we found another game against Wish. Okay, pretty nice hog because it also pulls back the Barbarian. That's gonna get no hits, all good. I guess I can skeletons, nice, pulled the both early bobs. Oh wow, this guy's level 13. This guy's level 13, that's alright. I mean, it doesn't really matter because this is for sure my matchup. Okay, I'll just ghost, just ice golem the ghost. Okay, I'm gonna go hog immediately because he just spent so much elixir and there's no way he has back to elite barbarians. Oh, well, he might be, yeah, he is back to it, but he didn't have enough elixir to destroy a player, so yeah. Pretty nice hog there, and my cannon will not only kill the ghost and the bandit, it's gonna help kill the elite bub, so yeah. I'm gonna go hog again probably because he just spent so much elixir and yeah, doesn't have elite barbarians. Let's go for ghosts. Okay, that's absolutely fine. This is pretty annoying that I don't have skeletons because ice spirit is pretty bad against a ghost, so I think I have to just sacrifice a cannon. Or I might even just go for his elixir collector is level 12. Does that matter? I don't. If I poison, I think he still gets like the same amount of elixir. I'm actually have no idea, but I'm not gonna fight poison it because Well, it feels weird saying poison. It's usually just, it's usually always just, I'm not gonna like fireball about it. Now it's poison. Yeah, I didn't want to poison it because I thought he would have like mirror or something like that. And that's fine. I think poison is pretty good in this matchup because it fully kills. It fully kills a 3 and but it will take a while for him. So if he plays it in like the. If he plays it in the back, it's pretty good poison because I can just poison it and then it will die. But if he plays it in like in the bridge, like splitting 2-1 in the bridge, I feel like it'll be pretty annoying to defend that. Yeah, that's exactly what I mean. Oh crap. Okay. Whew, man, that's okay, nice sitting in here. Maybe I shouldn't have poisoned like that. I should have just poisoned the two musketeers in the left. Yeah. For sure. I should have just poisoned the two musketeers in the left lane. I probably shouldn't have just ignored that. Because he's gonna do the same thing again, isn't he? Yeah, so predictable. He thinks cause it worked once, it's gonna work again. No, it's not gonna work again. Like it worked once, it's definitely not going to work on me again. Yeah. So I think just poisoning the 2M and just defending the 1 musketeer, I think that's a play. Because not only the poison will kill the 3M, but will also kill like his other stuff he uses in front of the 2 musketeers. Okay, I'll just poison that. Wait, I just realized spell cycling is going to take forever. Nah, GG's. Yeah, I'm just going to get a hog here just to be... take out his health because there's no way he will take out my there's no way he can take out my Hogwarts. So yeah, GG's. Pretty easy matchup. Okay, so we found another game against this guy. This is probably my last game. So far pretty good video. 4 wins, 0 losses. Hopefully it's great. Grub and true. Oh man. I hate when they defend with Skeleton Army. Like, I hate when they use Skeleton Army to defend my Hog. Because my Hog already gets no hits and I have to defend the Skeleton Army. I'm not sure if Poison or Fireball is better. Maybe Poison. I don't know. If he has Inferno Tower. I don't know. Yeah, it's still going to be annoying. Wait, here's... maybe I can get Hog Poison for his Skeleton Army because Fireball does... Fireball is not good because it won't fully kill the Skeleton Army. But Hog Poison will. And this guy doesn't know that I have Poison. So once I outcycle his... he might go for Wall Breaker. Yeah, perfect. Predictable. If he goes for this... it's gonna Fireball. Yeah, there's literally nothing I can do right now. I can't even go for a Hog because he'll just Skeleton on me. Maybe I can now because the Ice Golem is still alive, so he has to go for Inferno Tower. Yep. Okay, that's good. So once I outcycle his Inferno Tower, I want to get Hog Poison because I feel like I want to use my log on his drill, and then he'll think that I don't have any like counters to his Skeleton on me because he's seeking out Fireball. Fireball isn't a good counter to Skeleton on me, so and then I pull out the Poison and then. Hopefully I get a lot of damage. Okay, I think now is a perfect opportunity. There's no way he's back to Inferno Tower, and I'm pretty sure he's gonna go for a poison right here. Nice, let's go. Predictable. Oh my, that's annoying. Now he knows I don't have the surprise factor anymore, and yeah, I didn't even get any damage on his tower, bro. Okay, I'm gonna poison again. Okay, that's fine. It's fine. Okay, I think poison is better in this matchup. And him having Bomber makes it so much easier. If you had Dark Goblin, Dark Goblin is really, really annoying. Because I won't be able to place my cannons like this because he'll be able to snipe it with a Dark Goblin. Okay, I'm gonna get poison again. Nice. And he had Inferno Tower hand. Like he had the Inferno Tower, but I had a feeling he was gonna go for Skeleton Army to defend it. So that's why I went for a Hog. I'm actually I'm always going to go Hawk Poison no matter what. I think it's, even if you guess my Funnel, I think it's fine. Yeah, nice. Maybe you can get one hit. Nice, 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 nice. Okay. Nice, nice. The cannon was literally 1 HP and it stopped Warbreaker. Okay, log, come on, log, log. Oh, wait, I can't log it now. Maybe now I can, yeah. Luckily, I didn't log it too early because if I did, then I would have probably lost it because that Goblin Jewel would have not died to my log. So you have to be careful when you want the Goblin Jewel has to be like less than half HP, like just a little bit less. Oh man, the fireball. But the good thing is that the fireball doesn't do a lot of knockback, so. Okay, nice. My poison hit his Fernatava. So this is getting pretty close right now. Gonna try to outcycle. Okay, that fire spirit, I can't let it connect. Oh, he missed his Inferno Tower. Poison Skeleton on me? Yeah, this should be GG's. Yeah, GG's. Let's go. Nice, nice, nice. GG's. I think we're top 100 right now. Let's just see where we ended up real quick. Nice, top 131. And yeah, see you guys in the next one.